That is some smooth velvet.
Well, fellows, we've beaten these Axis forces all over the map. We've pushed them into every corner we've needed to, but the bastards, they just don't give up. Not only have their stupid little egos prevented them from finally pulling the plug on this stupid war, but now they've come after me personally. Me. That's right. I've just received word that a combined infantry force of 3rd Reich and Rising Sun Infantry has just landed at my lake home in Minnesota, right here. Just to piss me off. Well, guys, they succeeded. We're gonna take my lake home back from these bastards. Gentlemen, this is how I want this operation to proceed. At 0730, I want the 78th Airborne to drop back here behind this bunker. And after the main force lands on the beach at 0800, I want the Airborne to assault the forward deployment area here. The main force will land at this point with our reserves holding back in support, and after we've achieved a semi-secure beachhead, I want the Airborne to deploy from here and obtain the objective. So if everything goes as planned, we'll all be sitting around and having our supper about this time tomorrow night when Captain Samuel's dropping his tanks off on the beach. Does anybody have any questions?
General, I'm not sure I can have my men rallied up and in position in time to move on the forward deployment area before the main landing. Is there any way we could build an extra 15 minutes into the schedule for my drop?
Well, Bill, I don't have a problem with that. Why don't you just go ahead and advise Captain Hansen on the way out to the plane tomorrow morning? Is there anything else?
Sir, I don't think that Captain Simpson can have the beach secured in time for me to deploy my tanks before nightfall. That last lady...
You know we were slowed by lack of air cover, Samuel! The Navy didn't do their goddamn job knocking out the batteries, and we were pinned down for...
You and your troops need to take the fight to the enemy! There's nothing on that shoreline to defend!
Alright, that's enough. I'm not gonna have my most experienced officers sitting around my table and whining about things they can't control. We're gonna hit them in the morning. We're gonna hit them hard. Those pansies on the other side of the stream, they better take their morning craps, or they're gonna be shitting their pants.
You there! We'll cover you! Go!
Yet. Not yet. We'll wait here at the rally point for the others. We better get going. We lost a couple guys back there on the roof.
This German's headed this way.
You gotta take out that machine gun position around this building. You guys are gonna follow me.
Captain, what's happened to you?
What's up, Donnie? You just cut in half.
Captain, you've got a lot of work to do. Unless you want more guys to end up like Donnie, you're gonna have to pull it together. Captain, look at me. You need to lead the assault on that machine gun battery. You're gonna need to get off your sorry ass and man up.
You're right, Sergeant Morgan. Let's go kill these sons of bitches.
Thank you. India 5! Fire mission! Over!
Roger that, Simpson. This is Bravo Battery. We are vectoring fire on your position. Out.
Incoming! Fire in the hole! Incoming! Fire in the hole!
Looks like the fellas have finally broken through. I knew we'd stick it to those losers in the end.
That's right, sir. Looks like Steve and his boys got it handled. I've got my boys readying the landers. The beach will be secure in a few moments, then the tanks will roll.
Now all that's left is that we grab the secret docks and head on back to the boat.
Dynamite defused.
Whoops.
The enemy's weakened.
Hello.
Yeah. Undaunted soldiers from the 1996 vacation years are seen here fearlessly boarding their invasion craft as their weak and demoralized enemy waits on the other shore. With their hearts and minds overflowing with confidence and bravery, our troopers patiently waited for the trip into battle. After wiping away the futile defense that met them on the beaches, our forces achieved yet another great victory for the Stars and Stripes. Here we see General Aviation and his staff going ashore to view the beachhead and discuss the utter devastation that was brought upon the enemy by the forces under his command. These veteran soldiers and a never-ending stream of many more like them are spearheading their way to the heart of the enemy on their way to total victory. A firm handshake and a resounding congratulations to each of these boys for a job well done.
Think of all the things that really matter and the chances you